Hi, Nora. Have a nice Christmas.
Yeah, you know, me and my mom and dad.
Sounds nice. So, your girlfriend Christy didn't cook you Christmas dinner and then tell you she was dumping you because you spend too much time at work.
Dave, I'm really sorry. You and Christy have so much... What's it been, 3 months?
But it's over now. I threw out that damn fern and caught up with some old friends in the lesbian chat room. Super glued the toilet seat into the upright position.
Dave, don't you also...
Yeah, I know. I discovered that in the middle of the night. It was cold. So very cold. But not colder than what she did to me.
Midweek blues got you down?
Sometimes.
Try some Midweek Red to pick you up.
I leave out the dull parts.
Why not a weekly rendezvous with Redford?
Aren't you impressed?
Thursdays with Robert, tonight at 8 on WE, Women's Entertainment.
Thank you, thank you.
Childhood was a time to dream, to be free, and where anything was possible.
When I write and when I sing, it comes from my heart and from my soul.
Wow, that's heavy. You know, that's deep. That's music.
Kick off the new year with a new you. Join WE Women's Entertainment January 18th at 10 Eastern when we give four women life-changing makeovers on New Year, New You. Then go to www.we.tv to enter the New Year New You sweepstakes, brought to you by Slim Fast and Payless Shoe Source. You could win your very own makeover weekend in New York City. You'll be treated to the hippest hotel and restaurants, spa and salon services, shopping, and more. New Year New You. We'll make your resolutions reality.
Guess what, y'all? I'm a big loser. I'm doing it with a whole new plan from Slim Fast. And I know you heard me, child, Slim Fast. So shake the notion of just shakes out of your head. There's pasta, soup, ice cream. Here's the deal. With Slim Fast counting the calories, you can lose twice the weight than if you were counting those calories yourself. Twice the weight. That's my kind of plan. Got a yen for a 10? Want to delve into a 12? Come on. If I can be a big loser, there's nothing stopping you. Lose big. Get started at slimfast.com.
Kiss a scrape to make it better. You do a little dance to make the tears stop. You've learned a million things to help your little one. Like what to do at the first sign of diarrhea. You give them Pedialyte. Because soda and sports drinks can be so high in sugar, they can make diarrhea worse. Pedialyte has the proper balance of fluid and electrolytes to help prevent dehydration. It's all part of a learning process that never ends. But why would you want it to? Use Pedialyte.
You'll feel so confident underneath it all. You'll feel so carefree underneath it all. Because underneath, you're wearing new Carefree Perfect Fit Panty Liners for light protection. The most flexible panty liner available. It's like it becomes one with your underwear. New Carefree Perfect Fit.
Spark? You want to know where the spark went? I used to think sex life. Mm-hmm. That's going to fit somewhere in between kids, work, cleaning, stress. Even if I was in the mood, I was just too tired. Well, that was before I heard about Aplomil.
The ingredients in Aplomil have been shown to enhance libido and promote a healthier, more energetic love life.
I tried it. I had passion. Who would have thought? Passion.
Now you can receive a free 30-day sample cycle. Just call or go online today.
I'd heard about Aplomil, but it was safe and natural.
Introducing Aplomil, the non-prescription once-daily supplement made just for women.
So I tried it. That's when I started feeling intimate again.
The ingredients in Aplomil have been shown to enhance libido and help maintain hormonal balance.
I had desire, energy. I had passion. This is how I really am. I'm back to being me.
Now you can receive a free 30-day sample cycle. Just call or go online today.
I'm Ronnie Deutsch. I have settled IRS tax bills for only $20. $20!
Ronnie was able to help us settle this debt for only $20.
Call the law offices of Ronnie Deutsch at 1-800-277-3377.
All right, you want predictions?
Okay, the spirits are about to speak.
For 1998, The Inquisitor predicts Catholics will raise an eyebrow when Mother Teresa is portrayed on the silver screen by the only woman more saintly than she, Whitney Houston.
Well, let's just do that as a musical.
Well, now it's just silly.
I got one. For 1998, The Inquisitor predicts death shall fall like black rain. The fields will run red with the blood of the innocent, and the living will envy the dead. Also, Julia Roberts' new look will wow fans and critics alike.
That's my girl.
Oh, dear, beer and pizza, and me without my toga.
Come on, Harris, pull up a chair and join the fun. We're writing New Year predictions.
Exploiting the myth of the paranormal to sell papers? Ooh, that does sound like fun.
Well, it did when Camilla said it.
Everything sounds like fun when I say it. Listen, sinus infection. Jury duty. Pap smear.
Come on, Harris. I mean, sometimes my horoscope is amazingly accurate. And even the police use psychics to help them solve crimes. I mean, you have to admit that there are things out there that can't be explained by science.
I think you've seen too many X-Files. All psychics are con artists, Nora. They employ a few well-known tricks to fool their mindless, gullible victims.
What did you call me?
I believe he said well-known trick.
I simply meant that if
I'll tell you what. Noon tomorrow, the tarot card reader down on the corner, and I will bet you that she gets at least one thing about you dead on.
Oh, let's make it an even bet. If she does, I abandon every intellectual principle upon which I have based my entire existence. If not, you buy me a burger. Don't do that. She's probably watching us right now, sizing up who we are, what we do.
What, I pick up a magazine and she's gonna know that we work at a tabloid? Oh,
shh. How silly you are! Imagine us, two ordinary steel workers working in a tabloid.
Steel workers?
I panicked.
Hi, welcome.
Hi.
My name's Alana. So, is this your first time?
Okay, could we just please skip straight to the mumbo and or jumbo? I'm a busy man. Or am I? Why don't you do me first, and then my wife will take a turn.
Your wife? Peg Joe is gay.
I'm sorry, you'll have to excuse my husband. What's your name again?
Gary.
Let's see. You're very precise, exact, fastidious.
Well, duh.
With an Ivy League education.
Harvard. How did you know that?
It's the book, The Creeping Vine, The Arrogant Fool. You do the math.
Keen eyesight. My tailor's label, The Crimson Shop, Harvard Square.
Your father is an engineer or a technician? Wait, a clockmaker.
Hardly. He's a civil servant. My mother is a family clockmaker. Which you, no doubt, deduced from the inscription on the back of my handmade watch.
That'd be the side pressed tightly against your skin, right?
You don't like to admit it, but you're colorblind.
Oh, come on, what is this, strip tarot? She got 3 for 3. It's my turn, baby.
Oh, well, you're in good health, and your career is on the upswing, and looks like you're gonna come into some money.
She's good. Hit me.
Anything special you wanna know?
Well, when will I find true love?
Never.
I'm sorry, what?
Never.
Never?
Nope, never.
Wait. What do you mean? Like, never? I mean, that's an awfully long time, my whole life. Isn't that never? Like, pretty fine? Obviously, that is not what you're saying.
No, that's what I'm saying. You're never going to find true love. But, you know, the good news is that you're going to live for a very, very long time.
Me? Not have any true love?
Now, honey.
Shut up, Gary. Let me just tell you something, lady. I am so full of true love, I don't even know what to do with myself.
See, I told you going to a tarot reader was silly.
You were right. What we should have done is gone straight to a palm reader. Go.
Tell me something good. Tell me that you love me, yeah.
Nora. I felt you were so unnerved by all those predictions that I would bring you something slightly more scientific. Pick an integer. Obviously, you're still upset about what that demented psychic said.
Four demented psychics, Harris. Well, three. Zoltar's a robot.
Just because he's a robot doesn't mean he's not crazy. You see, Nora, this is exactly why I detest psychics. They toss off their semi-plausible claptrap with absolutely no regard for how it will affect people who give it credence.
Okay, so it's still bugging me. You know, I guess it's something that I've always been afraid of, ending up alone. I mean, that's a normal fear, isn't it? Here it is, another year gone by, and I still haven't found anybody.
You know what your problem is? Like all women, you buy into this insane fairy tale where the prince comes in and carries you off to his castle and never leaves his underpants lying around. Well, let me tell you, it ain't gonna happen.
Are you really that cynical?
Well, okay, I guess someday I'm still hoping to find the one, you know. Violins, goosebumps, cuddling on a rainy day.
Good God, Jake, you're more of a girl than I am.
Look, mostly, I just want to leave my underpants lying around.
Me too, but Camilla has this thing about office etiquette.
I don't know, Jake. I think someday everybody will find their own true love.
Well, good for you, Bradley.
Because we live in a world of miracles where even a lowly photographer like me can dream of one day marrying an Academy Award-winning actress, like Cher.
No, Bradley, I think the judge said that you couldn't dream about that anymore.
Yeah, but I'm appealing.
Keep telling yourself that.
I'd settle for a guy who could make me lose interest in Leno after the monologue. I mean, besides Leno.
Keep aiming high, Suji. Someday you'll find your perfect match.
Thanks.
Then boom, she'll dump you. And you'll spend the rest of your life avoiding prying eyes in the 10 items or less lane.
Cheer up, Dave. Maybe you'll meet someone at the office party.
Yeah, sure. Maybe I'll find the light of my life in a room full of drunk, horny people I see every day.
I'm not drunk every day.
I mean, I work 70-hour work weeks. And, I mean, how am I ever going to meet anybody? I didn't have a date for the New Year's Eve party.
You're not alone.
I don't have a date.
Jake? You neither?
Hey, dry spell. Everybody has them. My Porsche's in the shop.
This is great. You're all as pathetic as I am.
Hey, I've got an idea. Why don't we all fix each other up? You know, like a kind of secret blind date exchange sort of thing.
How pathetic is that?
Very. I like it.
Me too. I mean, just because Alana says that I'll never find true love doesn't mean that I have to sit at home and shut myself off from the world like some kind of nun. Some kind of drinking, smoking, angry nun. Count me in. Come on.
This better not be like that Secret Santa gift exchange. Everybody else got cash. I got a peppermill shaped like Napoleon.
It wasn't Napoleon. It was Dudley Moore.
Then why did it say Vive le Pepper when I twisted it?
It was made in China. They don't know what Dudley Moore says.
Hey, Camilla, you need a date for New Year's? We're drawing names.
Oh, dear Lord, are we pairing off at random? God, it's like Jack Cassidy's moon landing party all over again.
Not with ourselves. We're finding dates for each other.
Well, yeah, it always starts that way.
Next, what's holding up her strapless? Bridget Fonda's got an uplifting design. Tonight, it's Thursdays with Robert. Join him for a hot trip to Havana and stay warm with Paul Newman in the long, hot summer. Then, is it smart to get married while you're still in college? Ask Felicity. Turn up the heat and kick off your shoes. We, Women's Entertainment.
They say laughing burns 120 calories an hour. That means that watching sitcoms on Wii from 6 to 8 will burn 240 calories.
I feel like an enormous weight has just been lifted.
That's half a cup of ice cream or one slice of pizza. Now, if I tape and watch each show twice.
We laugh. Tonight at 6 p.m. only on Wii. From princess to pregnant in one night, it's a double date you just can't miss. Robin Wright Penn is the princess bride.
I love Wesley.
Then, who will win the single mom's love? It's the Playboys. Two movies, one Robin. It's a double date. Tomorrow night, beginning at 8 Eastern, we, Women's Entertainment.
You don't have to live with all the hot flashes and night sweats of menopause. You've got options. Try all-natural extra-strength Estroven to reduce hot flashes and night sweats. Extra-strength Estroven helps improve mental clarity and reduce irritability. You've got options.
I just want to feel clear, wide open.
I want to re-enter the world.
I just want the pressure to leave.
I want to feel like myself again.
I want my head back.
Introducing new Tylenol Sinus Severe Congestion.
I was stuck, now I'm unstuck.
It relieves congestion, pressure, and has Tylenol for pain, so it relieves more symptoms than even the leading sinus prescription.
I'm back in the land of the living.
No more singing the blues.
New Tylenol Sinus Severe Congestion.
Gone.
Guess what, y'all? I'm a big loser. I'm doing it with a whole new plan from Slim Fast. And I know you heard me, child, Slim Fast. So shake the notion of just shakes out of your head. There's pasta, soup, ice cream. Here's the deal. With Slim Fast counting the calories, you can lose twice the weight than if you were counting those calories yourself. Twice the weight. That's my kind of plan. Got a yen for a 10? Want to delve into a 12? Come on. If I can be a big loser, there's nothing stopping you. Lose big. Get started at slimfast.com.
Don't miss the Payless Shoe Lovers weekend. This Thursday through Sunday only, buy two, get one free. It's our hottest sale of the season. Look smart, pay less.
Remember why you got DirecTV in the first place? If it was to see movies, then you need to call 1-800-391-4388 and ask for Stars. When you add the Stars Super Pack to your DirecTV subscription, you get 12 distinct channels with over 600 different movies a month. Movies like Gangs of New York, Shanghai Nights, and Chicago. And all it's going to cost is $12 or less a month, about the same as renting a few videos. Call 1-800-391-4388 and ask for Stars or visit DirecTV.com.
Fish.
There I go.
They're just like us. Only flakier.
Find a happy place, find a happy place, find a happy place!
One of them...
We're looking for Nemo!
...is missing.
Fish are friends, not food.
Walt Disney Pictures presents a Pixar Animation Studios film.
I'm coming, Nemo!
Heading. Finding Nemo, rated G.
Oh, my stomach.
Nice.
Order it now on pay-per-view.
Dave Fontaine, I'm a huge fan. This is Leo. I brought him to meet, I'm not supposed to say yet.
She's not the one, is she?
Yes, Dave, I'm not the one, am I?
So how do you two know each other?
Steve and I dated a couple of years ago. The month we went out, Steve started making a lot of throwing errors. He dumped me.
Well, the sex was okay, but, you know, I had a career to think of.
Dave? If Leo is my blind date, you're gonna wish you were dead.
I already wish I was dead. All I can think about is Christy this and Christy that. Mostly Christy that. So you brought Steve for Camilla, right?
How'd you know?
I remember that game we took her to. She screamed her lungs out for him. She doesn't know anything about the sport. She just liked it when you bent over in the on-deck circle.
Okay, come on, everybody. There's no point in waiting for Camilla. Let's get started. Jake?
I drew Dave. And to help you forget about Christy, I brought Heather.
Heather? She's a trained masseuse.
Wow, a masseuse, you know? Christy once thought about getting a massage. She had a crick in her neck.
Who'd you draw, Dave?
That would be Suji.
Oh, and Dave lives to see the new year.
Suji, this is Leo.
Kind of scrawny. What have you got to say for yourself?
I only like Asian women.
What's in it for me?
I only like Asian women.
Oh, Dave.
Yeah, I'm sorry, but I had a lot on my mind, and, you know, you are an Asian woman.
That's the only kind of women I like, Asian.
I drew Bradley. Ah. Meet Shara.
Whoa, how's it going, Tiger?
Oh, my God, it's Cher.
No, it's Cher.
I'm a lookalike.
Oh, well, you know, that's actually even better because, you know, the real Cher's actually into playing mind games, you know, like not returning my phone calls and having me beaten.
Babe, she sounds like a horrible, horrible woman.
No, no, she's really an angel. She really is. All right, well, I drew Harris, and I know these were supposed to be blind dates, but...
Oh, Gary.
Explain or die.
I'm sorry, I heard you saying how much you hated her, and, well, me thought you doth protested too much, as Kenneth Branagh once said.
Jake.
Yeah, I found the sort of woman you should date, but never do. She's a professor of Egyptology at USC. Arlene?
Harris, I don't want to spend all night talking about Egypt. One time I saw a movie with a mummy in it.
Well, I guess Camilla and I must have drawn each other. And apparently she's advocating a major lifestyle change for me.
Make it.
Hi, sorry I'm late. I had to pick up Katrina here. Jake, the minute I drew your name, I thought of her. She's an optician.
One time I saw a movie with a mummy in it.
Wait a minute. Camilla and I couldn't both have drawn Jake's name unless some...
Bradley.
Okay, so maybe I made a little mistake with the names, but you're the guys that drew them.
Oh, well, that's just great. So nobody drew my name? Can't get fixed up right. All right, Camilla. Meet Steve Sachs. Play ball.
Steve Sachs. Steve Sachs. Oh, now I remember.
You know, there's an upside to never finding true love. You don't have to bathe, don't have to shave. It's like living in Paris. The most romantic city in the world.
Anybody ever tell you that your eyes are a lot like Christie's? Oh, what am I saying? You must get that all the time.
You know, you're kind of cute. We're an overeducated, colorblind Poindexter.
Well, be that as it may, my keen analytical skills are no match for your eerie psychic powers. You still claim to have those, right?
Oh, yes, I have them. And right now, they're telling me that I'm about to meet someone far, far more interesting than you. Oh, look, there he is now.
Another example. My friend keeps fish, and he's got this one kind that has, like, 4 or 5 females for each male. But to me, that's greedy. All a fish really needs is one female. Or the outside two.
Nora, I'm sorry your blind date didn't, well, exist. But if it's any consolation, I do believe there's a perfect match for everyone somewhere in the world.
Harris, you're just saying that.
No, it's true. Unfortunately, I did once prove that the probability of actually ever finding that perfect match approaches zero with the birth of each new person. But should some terrible plague strike the Earth, wiping out a large portion of the species, things start looking up. Unless, of course, your perfect match is among the dead.
You're not very good at this, are you?
Not particularly, no.
So, you're an impersonator, not just a lookalike, huh? Do you need a sonny for the act?
No, sweetheart. I've got a little sock puppet with a mustache.
Don't people ever feel cheated?
All the time.
Now, I understand that your position, you squat submissively in the dirt, wearing that provocative little mask, and move your fingers suggestively near your crotch, yes?
You're thinking of the catcher. I played second base.
Well, is there any reason why the second baseman couldn't wear a provocative little mask?
No, I guess not, but you make it sound so dirty.
Everything sounds dirty when I say it. Listen, sinus infection, jury duty. Naughty panty girl.
My father only liked Asian women, too.
What was your mother? A Japanese, Korean?
British. He didn't like her. Then he died.
I can snap you in two like mechanical pencil lead.
You know, guys give me that line a lot, pal. And usually I just slug them and walk away. But I'm feeling lonely tonight, and maybe I have had one Mai Tai too many. So, sure, go ahead. Tell me about the Unification Church. Swell. What happened with Cher?
Well, turned out she wasn't just a Cher impersonator. She was a male Cher impersonator. On top of which, she was already involved in a relationship. So, you know, there was the whole ethical question.
Suji?
Leo asked me to marry him. I said yes. We made out for 10 minutes, then I broke it off.
Dave, what about Heather?
Dumped her. All she could talk about were things other than Christy.
I think I must have scared Steve Sachs speechless. He wandered off in search of something a little less challenging.
He found it. He left with Arlene and Katrina.
And Heather.
Amateur.
Eris, what about you and Alana? You seem to be hitting it off for a minute there.
She left me for a small red cylinder filled with inert gas.
Okay, well, this has been fun. I think I'm gonna head on home and take my own life. See you Monday.
Dave, I'm sorry. Here we all are wallowing in self-pity while you...
That's me. Hello. Hi, Christy. You're lonely? Well, that's no way to spend New Year's Eve. Really? Aw, yeah. Yeah, I love you too. I'll be right over. Wrong number. Gotta go. Bye.
So, is this how it's gonna be 20 years from now?
I have been in the tabloid business long, long time.
Oh, this just gets better and better.
And I have reported on hundreds of wildly improbable stories. From a cat that composed a sonnet to a pumpkin that grew as big as a barn. And if there's one thing I've learned, it is that wacky, impossible things happen every day, including true love.
Look, I don't even care anymore. If I find true love, great. And if I don't, I don't. I'm making a New Year's resolution right now. I'm not gonna waste any more time hunting for silly little clues into the future.
Does that mean you're not going to read your fortune?
Oh, who cares what the stupid cookie says, Suji? I mean, am I gonna let something like this affect how I live? Look at it. You will find true love. Oh my God! I'm gonna find true love! I knew it! I knew it! I knew I was gonna find true love! Oh my God, I gotta go shower and call my mom and show that to the stupid Turkish robot.
Hey, this is weird. Mine says the same thing. You'll find true love.
Hey, mine too. What are the odds of that happening? Eris?
Normally astronomical. But they drop dramatically when you have access to the kitchen. And a very steady hand.
Eris, you sly dog. You're not the cold-blooded automaton you pretend to be.
You take that back.
Eris is a sweetie pie.
Oh, you sentimental fool.
Right. Give me here, you big lug. Give me one.
There you go.
You'll all pay dearly for this.